everybody, what's going on? Welcome back to Heavy Metal Models. The Fast and the Furious was the first film in a series of films that celebrated street racing and had some of the coolest and craziest cars ever put on film. Now, one of the cars that really stuck in our mind as Americans was the 1970 Dodge Charger RT, driven by the character named Dominic Toretto. That car met a bad end in the first movie, but it lives forever in our hearts. Now, Hot Wheels Elite has done a 1/18th model of the car that comes along in their entertainment series. And it's really quite a nice model. Check it out. Classic cars don't come much hairier than the wheel-standing, ground-pounding 1970 Dodge Charger that starred in the very first Fast and Furious movie. And, much like another famous Charger, few cars have ever returned so many times after being utterly destroyed on film. With 900-plus horsepower on tap and a profile that positively screamed American muscle, the car that was driven by character Dominic Toretto was a menacing machine amongst a bevy of import tuners. Hot Wheels Elite has patterned this very well-done 1/18th replica after the Charger scene in the first film. And right out of its box, the model showed some serious attention to detail and a healthy heap of correctness when compared to the movie car. The first thing that grabbed me was the paint. It's an amazing, deeply polished black that lays on the model's body without a flaw, starting at the removable die-cast hood and carrying through its opening doors and trunk. All of the shut lines are very good, and the car's sleek stance on fat and skinny tires with sparkling mag wheels is spot on. Up front, Hot Wheels has replicated the Charger's eyes wide open look with some great castings for the grille and deeply lensed headlights. More lensing is in the splash pan for the amber directionals, and those are joined by bezeled reflective side markers front and rear. Out back, the car's customized taillight treatment adds to its jacked-up pose above a perfectly chromed bumper and correct license plate. The car's trim is here, and it's scaled correct from the foil-based applied chrome around the windows to the hard flashed pieces surrounding the front and rear glass. Neatly done door handles, a lowered antenna, and a proper set of chromed windshield wipers join the classic Charger gas cap to round out the wicked B-body Mopar's decoration. Lifting of the model's hood brought a slick little Hemi into view, and a few minutes freeze-framing the DVD to compare the motor to the one in the film had me giggling at how closely Hot Wheels has replicated the hero car's power plant, right to the blue fuel lines, the red ignition leads, and even the injector pipes and cracked open butterflies in the blower scoop. Beneath that scoop and the accompanying chrome valve covers, the engine boasts a full-on block that's been metallized with a condensing aluminum sheen, all set behind a tidy hypo radiator and electric cooling fan. The Charger's no-fooling-around cabin is here in a neat bunch of castings and even neater texturing and paint, from the wood-tone dash and its readable gauges to the grand-styled race wheel and top shifter set onto a meticulously done bare floor. Faux aluminum door panels and rear deck add to the lightweight nature of the big Dodge's gutted control room. Details like the full roll cage, fire bottle, and an awesome race seat with a fabric harness and photo-etched buckles really sealed the deal. A look under the Charger's trunk lid had me giggling all over again. A creditable pair of N2O labeled blue bottles are set beside a racing fuel cell, and a few well-picked anodized details make the area worth displaying the model with the trunk lid up. More great detailing is under the car, and more freeze framing of the Charger's end-over-end demise at the end of the film had me giving major props to Hot Wheels for replicating every important chassis detail of Toretto's ride, from the impressive headers and steering gear up front to the full-on, separately cast dual exhaust, twin mufflers, and pair of tailpipes. The heavy-duty torque flight and fully realized rear end, complete to the shock absorbers, make the nicely engraved, cast, and painted over belly of Dom's beast worthy of a wheel stand. Classic movie machines like Dom Toretto's Charger thrill us when they appear on screen. Models as well done as this one allow collectors to bring those thrills home. This entertainment series is proving to be a pretty strong segment for Hot Wheels Elite because they've really stepped up their game. I've said it before, I'll say it now, I hope to say it again in the future. These guys don't just make a model of a famous movie car. The model underneath all of those recognizable movie details is usually a very good model of the car that that movie car is based on. So what we have here is a customized 1970 Dodge Charger RT. They've done a great job with this thing. Does that mean that they'll ever give us a stock Dodge done to this level of detail? Hey, we can only hope. It's a very cool model car. Hey, if there's something you want to see on Heavy Metal Models, let me know. joe@heavymetalmodels.com. Join us on our Facebook page. I keep saying it. They're a great group of guys. I think you'd have a great time there. And of course, subscribe to us right here on the YouTube channel so that every time there's a new video, you get an email and you know it's up and ready to be viewed. Thanks a lot for coming down. We'll talk to you real soon. Take care.